Aquí, bismillahirrahmanirrahim, assalamu alaikum. Salam sejahtera. Okay, so this is the last topic for final, okay, which is beams external effects. Okay, so okay, what are beams? Okay, beams are structural members which offer resistance to the bending, okay, due to applied loads. Okay, and then in order to analyze the load carrying capacities of a beam, we must first establish the equilibrium requirements of the beams as a whole, okay, and then second, we must establish relations between the resulting forces and the accompanying internal resistance of the beam. Okay, and then type of beams, okay. There are two types, okay. First, beams are supported so that their external support reactions can be calculated by the methods of statics alone, are called statically determined beams. Okay, and then the second beams is this one has more supports than needed, okay, extra supports to provide the equilibrium, so we call this statically indeterminate. Okay, so this is statically determined beams, this one statically indeterminate beams, okay, which mean this has extra supports, okay. Extra supports then needed, okay. So for today, we are going to focus only on statically determined beams, okay. Okay, so we can see here that, okay, figure 518 are supporting concentrated loads. Okay, this one before, okay, 518, this one is concentrated loads, okay, meaning at one point, okay, the load is being put at one point, okay, and then we can see at figure 519 is supporting a distributed load. Okay, so here is the distributed load, okay, this one, okay, this one is distributed load. Okay, and then, okay, so the intensity is can be vary, okay, it can be constant, okay, it can be constant. I just highlight the word, so constant is here, okay. Okay, this one is constant, okay. So we call this one as constant. Okay, and then we have variable, okay. Variable, okay. So in this case, maybe put this one. Okay, so variable. So you can see, this is variable and this one is also variable, okay. So variable, and then we can also see here there is discontinuous, this word. Discontinuous, okay, which mean, okay, so at this point the magnitude change, okay? So this one we call this continuous. Okay, then okay, so this one. Okay, so since we have known what is distributed load, now we want to find the resultant load. Okay. So in this case, okay, we see figure A, okay? A here. Okay, so so this one is the resultant. Okay, so how to calculate the resultant? Okay. First, this is the formula, okay? In order to calculate resultant is we have R, okay, and then integration W dx. So in order to solve, so we just solve R equal to Wx, okay? So here in this case, okay, we have W here, okay? We have W. Okay, we have W here, and then we have X here, which is L. Okay, so we just R equal to WL. Okay, this one, and then okay, since this one is rectangular, so we know that the centroid will be at the center. Okay, so it will be L over 2. Okay. So it is general knowledge, okay, for rectangular, okay, like this. So the centroid will be at the center, okay? Okay, and then, okay, so I just highlight here. These are the resultant passes through the centroid of the area. Okay, so now we see for okay, this one, the rectangular one. Okay, so rectangular, sorry, triangular. Okay, for this case, you can see that the height here is W, right? And then the X here is L. But in this case, the area is in rectangular. So what happen is R will be equal to the rectangular area, which is 1 over 2 multiply with height, which is W, and multiply with its width, so it is L. Okay, so we have to beware the type of distributed load, either it is rectangular or triangular. Okay. Okay, so and then we have in part C of figure 520, the trapezoidal area is broken into rectangular and triangular area. Okay, so in this case, figure 520, we have trapezoidal, right? Okay, so this is the okay, so this is the original area. Okay, so what we have to do is okay, and then I forgot to say that okay, for triangular, the centroid will be here, it will be 2/3L, okay, starting from the lowest point, okay, towards here, okay, to okay, 2/3 length. Okay, so as you can see here, the centroid will be 2/3L. Okay, starting from the lowest point towards the center, okay? Okay, and then, okay, so, I think I forgot. Okay, so for this one, I just pick it. For this one, okay, I just. Okay, so I just draw. Okay, like this. Oh, and then we just break it into two parts. Okay, so don't forget the label. So this is W1. So this is W2, and then we have okay. So now we break it into rectangular first. Okay, now we calculate the rectangular first. Okay, so it will be this one. Is W1, and then we have L. Okay, so the centroid will be in the center. Okay, so R will be here. Okay, the distance will be L over 2. Okay, and then this is R. Okay, so how to calculate R? R is equal to the area here, okay? So it will be WL. Okay, now we calculate for the triangular. Okay, now the length here is W2 minus W1. And then we have this width, which is L. Okay, now. So where is the centroid? Okay, always remember the centroid will be around here, okay? From here towards here, it will be 2 over 3. Okay, 2 over 3 L. Okay? So this is the R. Okay, and then how to calculate the R? The area, okay? So R will be equal to 1 over 2 W2 minus W1 multiplied with L. Okay. Okay, and then, okay. So, but what if the shape is not, okay, this figure, the shape is not either in rectangular or triangular. Okay, so we have to find the centroid using this formula. Okay, this is the centroid. Okay, x, and then we have integration xw dx over r. Okay, so now we see the example. Okay, so in this example, we have to determine the equivalent concentrated load, okay, and external reactions for the simply supported beam which is subjected to the distributed load shown. Okay, so the key here is we have to find equivalent concentrated load and also external reactions. Okay, so first we just find the equivalent concentrated load. Okay, so in this case, we just can divide into two parts. Okay, which is first we can say this is the rectangular part. Okay, and then we have next is triangular part. Okay, Okay, now we do which one first? Okay, let's say we do the triangular first, okay? Sorry, the rectangular first. Okay, so okay, so never mind. Okay, so let's say, okay, so we just label again, so we know that this is 120 feet, okay, and then the length here is 10 feet, okay. Also, the centroid will be in the middle, so it'll be 10 over 2, right? Okay, so 10 over 2 is 5 feet. Okay, so now we are going to find the R. So R is rectangular area, which is we just say W L, okay, and then so W is 120, okay, and then multiply with 10 feet, so it will be equivalent to 1200. Okay, and then now we find for the trapezoidal, for the triangular, okay. Okay, so we have maybe, okay, so we have the length is equivalent to 6, okay. 6 feet, and then this one we have to minus 280 minus 120, so we will get 160 feet, okay, pound over feet, okay, and then so where is the centroid? The centroid should be from here to here, let's see, okay. This is R. So this one should be 2 over 3 length. So which is 2 over 3, 6. So it is equivalent. Okay. 2 over 3 L. Okay, so L is 6, okay? So 2 over 3, 6 equal to 4. So equal to 4 feet. Okay, and then we want to calculate the R. Okay, R will be the area of this rectangular. So R will be equivalent 1 over 2 since it is triangular. And then the height, okay, which is 160 multiply with 6, so we will get equal to 480 pound, okay. Okay, and then so now we have find out the equivalent concentrated load. So now we just find the support force. Okay, so we just have to draw. So this is in the middle. Okay, so it will be 1200 lb. So the distance here is 5, okay, 5 feet, and then we have Okay, so this will be 2 right, okay? This one will be 2 feet. So from here, 2 feet from here, okay, let's say 2 feet from here is 480 pounds. Okay, and then we have RB here. RB, and then we have RA here. Okay, so now let's say we calculate summation of moment. Moment at A equal to 0. Okay, so this one will be, we have 1200 downward, and then to the A, towards A, okay, is 5. So 5, the direction is left hand side, so it is negative. So negative. And then we have 480 downward, okay, and then towards A. Okay, so this one will be 3, right? Since overall is 10, so this one will be 3. Overall is 10, right? Okay. Okay, and then so this one is 3 plus 5, which is 8, okay. Towards A. So this is also left hand side, so it is negative. If then RB is down, upward, and then towards A is 10. Okay. Is 10. Okay, so the direction is, this one is using right hand side, so it's positive, and then equal to 0. Okay. So, then okay. So we just calculate, then 10 RB equal to 9840. So RB is equal to 9 8 4 8 4 pound. I'm not sure, I'm just saying this is point, perhaps it is the correct terms. Okay, so and then we want to find RA, so we just summation moment at B equal to 0. Okay, so and then we have RA. Okay, RA upward, and then going towards B, 10. Okay, 10. So this is left hand side, so it is negative. So negative, and then we have 1200 downward, and then towards B is how much? 5. Okay, so this is right hand side, so it's positive. Okay, and then we have 480 downward, going to the right towards B equal to 2. So this one is right hand side, so it is positive. So positive equal to 0. Okay, so we have negative 10 RE equal to negative 69 6, 0. So we have RA equivalent to £696. Okay. So that's it. So later I show you the last one.